and she's still making music that blows my mind. She's not here. Beyonce. Ladies and gentlemen, here comes Beyonce, imagine, in my dreams. Is anybody going to go and see her? She's playing England. I'm so upset, I can't see her because I'm on tour, and then when she plays England in London, I'm in Minneapolis. But life goes on, it'll be okay. But anyway, yeah, that's my little rant about Beyonce because I love her so much. Ladies and gentlemen, here we have Tim, a.k.a. Banner. That's true name. And we also have Ben. Who normally wears a hat.
Are you showing us how long your hair's getting and how long your beard's getting?
Me and Ben went to school together. We've known each other since we were 16. I know. We met. I used to be a smoker. I used to smoke a lot. You still smoke, don't you? I gave up. But I asked, or he asked me for a lighter, and now look at us. On stage in Stockholm. Oi, oi. Any other smokers in the audience?
I know, I love smoking. I've got a shame.
Has anybody got tickets tonight for their birthday? Oh, nice. Happy birthday to all of you. Has anybody, happy birthday? Anybody come as a belated Christmas present? Merry Christmas to you. Anybody come for an anniversary? Oh, a few. Well, happy anniversary. Anybody been dragged along by their other half? It's okay. I won't. Oi, oi. You look happy about it, though. Well, I won you over. I don't mind, honestly. It's fine if you're happy, because I'm going to win you over. Win you over. Anyone that's been dragged along. There was this one man in London, his wife had dragged from him. He was livid. I don't know if it was a football match or something on, but I didn't manage to win him over. I thought he was going to punish me the whole time. He was not happy about it. Anyway, we're going to do you, whoever's here, for whatever reason. Thank you so much for coming and spending your evening with us. I really, really do appreciate it. So I'm going to bring it down. I've also given you seats so that I don't look so lazy for when I sit down. This next one that I'm going to do for you is off of my new album, and I wrote it about a park that I kind of grew up on. It was like round the corner from my house, and I drove past it just before I wrote it, which was about a year and a half, 2 years ago now. And I got really sad because I hadn't been there for years, and it was all my friends that I used to go with. We've all just moved on with our lives. We're all friends still, but we don't get to see each other as much because life happened. So I wrote this song about it, which helped me. This is a million years ago.
I only wanted to have fun learning to fly, learning to run. And my heart decided away. I was young. Deep down, I must have always known that this would be inevitable. To earn my stripes, I have to pay, bear my soul. Thank you.
We've got Pete. Oh my god. What's that racket? Oh my god. I think he's alright. We're just waiting on a chair for Eric. Here we go. It's so big in here, I can't see very far. So when you scream, I get worried you're hurt or something.
Hello.
You look lovely. So this next one I'm going to do is off of my new album. I'm going to introduce everyone now. You're right there on your chair, Eric.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Eric.
We have Pete here on the bass. What's the bass called again? Oh, it's another new bass. When we were playing in London, and I'm not that superstitious, and it was my 13th show, and I know, and we're at this point in the show. Do you believe in 13? You think it's good? Well, the bass tried to fucking kill me. On the 13th show, the double bass missed me by an inch, nearly knocked me flat, killed me. Yeah, I know, so we've got a new bass, so this is another new one. But I got someone in London the show after to name the bass. It was this guy. He was like, call it this, but I can't remember. What was the name? Brian, that was it. He was like, call it Brian. So I called the bass Brian. That was that. But who's this now? I don't know, we'll have to have a little ceremony for that stage. But we have Derek over here on the snare. So this next one is off of my second album, and it's definitely one of my favourites off of it. And we always did it live, but never really did it for any TVs or radio or anything like that. And it wasn't a single, but it was definitely one of the ones on the album that, you know, gave the album its rock, I don't know, whatever, that made it kind of solid. But I have the tendency to burp during this song. I have no idea why. I think it's probably because I drink so much hot honey when I'm on stage, just to make sure that my throat is back up. But it's with the big note, I nearly go. So I warned you, okay? So maybe if you'd like to sing along with me on the big note, just in case I do burp, you don't hear. Okay? But this is one of my favourite songs.